is pleased to bring you our feature presentation.
Welcome back. So, I was hoping this wouldn't be three videos. I didn't want to spread this into three videos. But with recording and editing, it looks like it's going to be three videos. So, hopefully you guys don't mind. So, I'm going to start with the back page first, and I'm going to start with somebody new. Somebody else, I got a new person that asked me questions. It's exciting. He's a big guy. Actually, he's not that big. But he is big on the YouTube scene. He is big in the YouTube scene. He's big to me. His name is Retro Syphilis. And, oh, I'm sorry, Retro Cynical. And, he's awesome. If you don't know about him, obviously his links will be posted in the description below. But he does. If you don't know Retro Cynical, check him out. Okay, so Retro Cynical asks, if you could choose how you would die, how would you go out? And in your sleep is not an option. Honestly, this is a pretty tough question because I never thought of this before, and I didn't expect anyone to ask me a question like this. So lo and behold, Retro Cynical, of all fucking people, to ask me this. I would say I wouldn't want pain. I wouldn't want burning. I wouldn't want. Like, I feel like even getting, like, my neck chopped off, like, beheaded, guillotine, I wouldn't want that. I wouldn't want bullets, I wouldn't want stabbing. Honestly, probably the best way for me to go out would be the way that has always scared the shit out of me, and that would be breathing. I would probably want to just drown. I've been told that it is the closest to getting an injection, like there's the lethal injection. I've been told that is the, and like in your sleep is not an option, so I would say lethal injection, that's not an option either. That's an easy answer. If I were to pick legitimately a way to die, I'd say probably drowning, because I heard your lungs slowly fill with water and you take your couple last breaths, but you're still kind of alive. Because there's some air in water to a certain extent. And it kind of reminds me of like, God, I just can't think tonight, but The Abyss. It kind of reminds me of The Abyss when they like breathe in liquid. And yeah, so like, I think that would be how I'd want to go out. It's a little long. I heard for some people you can last a while. Like you can kind of look around and the whole world just gets cloudy. But I think that would be the best way to go out. Because you kind of enter the world in liquid and then you hit air. So, how appropriate to go back to said liquid, you know. So. Okay. Up next, we have Brenda, a.k.a. the Art Wench. She has some stuff on YouTube. She's not a big video maker, but she is a very big video watcher. Brenda, I cannot thank you enough. I always appreciate your comments. I always appreciate your likes. And, you know, I just honestly appreciate you taking the time out of your day to watch my videos. So thank you. Brenda asks, I mean, I assumed that this was a part of my questions, because this was the only question that you sent, so... it says, will I be attending Sci-Fi Valley Con? If so, would you live stream your journey? Sci-Fi Valley Con is a science fiction convention, horror, comic books, all that good stuff. In relation to what I'm into, that is actually very close to where I live. I know it's not until the summertime. I know the summertime is coming up soon, so I need to make up my mind. I'm not planning on it, but depending on my financial situation, if I'm able to, I would love to go. If I do go, I would love to have, obviously, some kind of, like, hotel room set up and that sort of thing, because I don't like to just go to one day for a convention. I like to kind of go for the weekend. So, I would love to go to the convention. I just need to figure out where I'll be staying and things like that, and if I can afford the hotel room. Because if I can bring a friend or two, then I can split the cost. But if it's just me going by myself, it can get kind of expensive. So, if you have any suggestions, Brenda, obviously you can personal message me on Facebook. But I would be very interested in attending Sci-Fi Valley Con. I've never been to Sci-Fi Valley Con. It sounds pretty cool. I did go to the website. So, thank you for that question. Up next, last on the question sheet, but certainly not least, he actually was not a part of the original recording. I actually had spoke about that in my previous video. I did a recording and some of the video didn't get recorded for some reason. I don't know what happened, but I'm sorry, Cinema Clown, but you were left out of the previous recording of said episode, but you are in it now. This camera is definitely filming now. You ask, let's just get straight to the point. Am I a cannabis smoker? I love that question. It's a very honest question. And I'm going to be very honest with you. Yes, I am. However, I'm not a regular cannabis smoker. I am more of a partaker in the area of it. I don't, with where I live and my setup, I'm not able to be a regular cannabis smoker. I wish I could be, but with the laws and the way things are set up in my state, it makes it very, very tough for me to be a regular cannabis smoker. So if I'm able to share, sharing is caring, I totally will partake in it. So for any of my viewers out there, if this shocks them, which it shouldn't, I'm sure a lot of you probably thought I'm stoned all the time, which actually I'm not. But, it's definitely something that I'm interested in, and I think there's a lot of health benefits in relation to it, and I think there is a lot of advancements and studying that we could get from said product, but unfortunately, a lot of people don't believe in it, and I believe in it, and I think it could make a difference. And I wish one day it will become sort of a global thing and not just a state to state, you know, or city to city. You know, I want it to be a legit thing. So I'm up there with you, dude. It's a battle. Question from Cinema Clown. Would you be willing to cannibalize just for the hell of it? I hate eating alone. That is a tough question. I mean, I've thought about this before. I know it sounds fucked up, but I thought about eating another human, and like, I mean, honestly, it depends. I mean, in the heat of the moment, if that's all there is to eat and you can't capture an animal and you need to survive, I mean, maybe I might. Would I cook it first? Probably, because I think human raw would taste really disgusting. But humans don't have meat on us the way animals do. You know what I mean? Like, I feel like humans would taste fucking disgusting just looking at some of them. But, like, when you look at a cow or, like, a pig, or like a duck or whatever you eat. You know, it's like, oh, they look cute and they look nice. And like, it's fucked up that you kill them. But then it's like, oh my God, they taste amazing. You like roast duck, like, mmm. But you look at a human and you're like, oh my God, why is this person at Walmart? Oh my God, what are they wearing? Why is that American flag tank top upside down? Oh my God, that's not even a tank top. You know, I think you guys are getting the point. So, yeah, I don't know, man. I mean, like, when you see that, like, when I see human, like, you see hair on a human, it's disgusting. When you see hair on an animal, it's cute. It's weird, dude. We live in a weird universe, dude. Another question from Cinema Clown. Anna wants to know if you own any possessed or cursed items. Unfortunately, I do not. I mean, at least I don't know if I do. I've bought a lot of used items over the years, like this poncho. So it could be haunted, however, or possessed or cursed. But, oh boy, aren't you coming back? I don't know, dude. Like, I've heard a lot of fucked up stories over the years, but I just, unfortunately, I don't have anything interesting to tell you. I wish I did, but I do thank you for the question. Alright, this is the last question from Colin Richards, a.k.a. Monsters and Markers, a.k.a. Markers and Monsters. Okay, hopefully I said that correctly. Would you rather be trapped in a Friday the 13th movie or a Texas Chainsaw Massacre movie? That is a pretty easy question. I would say Friday the 13th because in a Texas Chainsaw Massacre movie... I'm sorry. I fucked up already. I mean, I would not want to be in a Friday the 13th movie because almost everybody in a Friday the 13th movie dies, including the survivor sometimes, depending on the sequel. Whereas in the Texas Chainsaw Massacre, there's been a lot of survivors throughout the series. So obviously there is a very high chance you can survive. Even in the Next Generation, you could fucking survive that bullshit. However, you might be scarred for life. You might have nightmares forever. You might come out of it kind of fucked up. But the whole point is surviving for me. So I would say I'd rather be trapped in Texas Chainsaw Massacre. I'd rather walk away with the scars and the bruises and the memories rather than not walk away at all. Because Jason, as we all know, he'll get you. He'll get everyone. He'll get every last one of you. He'll get you every time. He'll get you. Okay. Now, next is Austin Wilcutt, a.k.a. the number one Jazzy fan. If King Kong took a shit in the middle of your street and someone offered you $1 million to clean every bit of shit, even the residue, LOL, off the street, would you refuse or happily do it and take the cash? I would happily do it and take the cash, absolutely. How do you feel about people in general right now compared to what they were like in the 80s, 90s, and 2000s? Holy fuck. Well, this is another loaded statement that I had answered previously, and my camera fucking deleted the footage for some fucked up reason. But to answer this question, just bluntly to the point, I do admit that as an adult, as I move forward, it seems like people are getting more irritated, more depressed, more angry, politics are changing, religion is changing, the world is changing, and people are definitely becoming upset. A lot of people don't like change, a lot of people do like change, a lot of people are scared of change. A lot of people want change, and things aren't changing fast enough. So that could cause people to act funny. But the big thing that I thought, Austin, you'd be interested in is a lot of us retro heads, as I call us, or nostalgia freaks, we look back through rose-colored glasses, and we look back at other times, and we go, things were different, or things were like that, and things really were awesome. But you have to keep in mind, how old were you when those things happened? You know, looking back on events as a kid, I was a child. So most adults probably ignored me. And I interacted with other children. As an adult, interacting with society, most adults interact with me, most children ignore me. So I think that plays a big factor in thinking that people have become worse. People have always been angry. People have always been rotten. People have always been assholes. But as a kid, there's always sort of been this overlying role of you don't really treat kids shitty. You don't act nasty towards kids, or at least you try not to. And I think, from my perspective, I thought the world was a better place when I was younger because I was a child. So being a child, even a teenager, or even in like young high school, most people just ignored me or didn't really interact with me because I was a kid. And they didn't really care to treat me any which way because I wasn't politically inclined or I wasn't religiously inclined or, you know, I didn't act a certain way that put me in a particular group. And I'm not... A lot of these questions can go on, and I think I should just kind of end it there. So I appreciate Austin, these questions, who is better known for his Markers and Monster series on YouTube. He asks, what is your drink of choice when you are on video? So my drink of choice is actually red wine. I'm sure you guys have seen me drinking, beer, in some of my, latest videos. If the price is right, I'll pick up some beer. I'm not a big beer fan, especially for videos because it gets me really gassy and it causes me to like burp a lot more, which obviously I enjoy burping. You guys enjoy the burping. At least I think you do. But either way, it is tough to talk when your body is like filling full of, when your lungs and stomach are filling full of gases that are going to cause you to burp. So I genuinely like to stick to red wine, or obviously just pure and simple tap water. Okay. So moving on, another question from, Monsters and Markers. What is the most anger-inducing game you've played? This one right here. Time Lord. You guys may have seen this. You may not have seen this. This is one of my earliest YouTube videos. It's very early, from like 2014, 2015. It's pretty old at this point. It's the only video game review I've done. I am planning on returning to that series at some point. If you watch the video, you'll know what I mean. I will actually post that video in the links, in the description, as a link in the description to the video, if you guys happen to view it. Although I didn't really answer it. What made me get upset about it? The controls were terrible. Okay, Austin Wilcutt, the biggest Jazzy fan, you sent in a lot of questions, so I'm just going to try and blow through as many of these as I can. What do you think is the best Friday the 13th movie in your opinion? The one movie that makes all the others movies is bitch. When I originally answered this question, I kind of dragged it out, but Cut and Dry Part 6. Jason Lives is absolutely phenomenal. I love the film. I love the deaths. I love the story. I love that they tried to change the name from Camp Forest Lake, Camp Crystal Lake, to Camp Forest Green. I love that they... I love the look of Jason. I love the characters, the camp counselors. I love that it's like a reopening. It's kind of like part two. It's reopening again, but this time it's finally the kids get there, and they finally show the fucking kids. And there's just a lot of cool things that make it feel campy. The docks, the official sign, the activities with the children. The soundtrack by Alice Cooper, Teenage Frankenstein, The Man Behind the Mask. I mean, there's just so many things I love about the film. It's so big budget, but it works really well. It still feels low budget. Tom McLaughlin, I believe, was a director. He was fucking phenomenal. C.J. Graham, I think, is actually the best Jason, hands down, better than Kane Hodder. And I know that's going to be a massive... I know that's like a massive statement right there. I love Kane Hodder, don't get me wrong. You know, the kill me. He's got the fucking word kill written inside of his lips. That doesn't make you a good Jason. That just makes you an awesome actor. But, yeah. I mean, for those that know Kane Hodder, he has a tattooed right here. Yeah, and if you get him to show it to you, it's pretty sweet. When I met Kane Hodder, he showed me that tattoo. That was like one of the first questions I had for him. But fucking Jason Lives, man. Great question. Next question. I have a little math question. LOL. Okay, Austin. You ask, how much cum would it take to fill a car till the tank is full? What would be the mathematical estimate? You can use a calculator. I mean, another question I answered already, and I know I went off the rails with that answer. I mean, cut and dry, dude. Every guy comes a different amount, to be honest. Some guys come more, some guys come less. So it would really depend on the guy or guys or the amount of cum being ejaculated. It's a tough... Yeah. So... Moving on. Do you see DVDs becoming obsolete/dead in the next 5 to 10 years like Laserdisc? How much time, realistically, does the format have? I'm actually kind of glad I'm answering this question again, because I feel like I went on way too fucking long last time. I mean, cut and dry, it's dead. I mean, DVDs are dead. However, I feel that Blu-rays are more dead than DVDs. We've had this discussion, Austin, multiple times. DVDs have been out for longer. More people are satisfied and happy with DVDs. And I'm not going to lie, there's some really good DVDs out there. Blu-ray, honestly, is a step up. And the clarity is a little crisper. And the sound is a little louder. And the overall flow of the film is less choppy and a lot more smooth. Transitions are smoother. Obviously, there's more space on the disc for special features and deleted scenes and, you know, cuts and alternate scenes and alternate endings. However, we've also had this discussion before, where Blu-rays, even though there's more space on the disc, they don't fill it up with all this stuff. There's lost scenes and lost, you know, alternate endings and alternate scenes that are still on VHS tapes and still on Laserdiscs that have not yet been ported to Blu-ray or not yet even been ported to DVD. There's been a lot of special features, interviews, promotional videos, documentaries, behind the scenes videos that have not been ported over to Blu-ray. So I ask you, why have these not been ported over? If there's more room on the disc, why wouldn't you fill the disc up with more material? Why would you not include more for the viewer? If you're spending more on the Blu-ray and you're spending more money for a better format, why not show off the format and fill it to its maximum capacity? Okay, moving along. You said in the comment section once that Laserdisc was actually better than DVD. Can you explain in depth why you thought they were better in your opinion? Well, as always, I'm always talking bullshit. I don't know the mathematical science behind why things are better, but I've seen a lot of comparison videos between Laserdisc and DVD, or Laserdisc and VHS, or Laserdisc and Beta, and my opinion of Laserdiscs being better than Blu-ray is basically to harp on what I said in the last question. They just put more on Laserdisc. There was more special features, more deleted scenes, more interviews with the cast, more commentary, more documentaries. There was just more stuff involved within the desk. And a lot of people have stated that the clarity on some of the laser discs is actually clearer and a little bit more crisper than DVDs. However, I believe DVDs did win in the sound department. So, I mean, this is a discussion that could go on and on and on and on. And you have to ask yourself, you know, what are the things that matter to you while watching a movie? Visuals? Sound? Or is it the actual film itself, the plot, the story? Or is it all of those things? Because some formats boast better picture, some formats boast better sound, some formats boast better everything, and then some formats don't boast anything at all. And that would be called DVD. Which girl in the Nightmare/Elm Street series was, besides Kim Myers slash Lisa, the most fuckable? Was the most fuckable. Oh man, Austin, you know how to hit home for me, dude. This is like probably my favorite question. I mean, dude, I love Kim Myers. I love Lisa. I want to fuck Lisa. I want to marry her. Like, I want to have children with her. Like, she was amazing. I don't know why, dude. I just, like, I fell in love with her from the start. For those who don't know who I'm talking about, Lisa, slash the actress's name is Kim Myers. She played Lisa in Nightmare on Elm Street Part 2. Bloody Dirty Girl Next Door. Either way, point is, Jesus Christ, dude, I'm falling apart right now. These movies, my God, I should just end the video right here. But, I actually thought the girl that was afraid of roaches in Part 5, I thought she was pretty fuckable. The nerdy girl with glasses from Part 5 that gets killed in the classroom, that's in, Freddy fucking sucks all the air out of her body. She was pretty fuckable. Part 4, the girl who replaced, the girl that played Kristen in Part 3, Patricia Arquette, she was replaced by another girl. She sang she sang the song for Part 4, Nightmare on Elm Street Part 4. The girl that replaced her, I thought she was really fuckable. So, I think this question has gone on, I think the answer has gone on long enough. I'm just going to fucking end this here. Moving along with another question from Austin. What is the worst Sega/NES game you have played? Honestly, I haven't played enough to really answer that question well. I mean, Shaq Fu on the Sega Genesis was really bad. That was also on the Super Nintendo. Top Gear was a fucking awful racing game. That was on the Super Nintendo. I don't know if it was on the Sega. High Seas Havoc was pretty fucking shitty on the Sega Genesis. Started out really cool, got really hard. Mighty Max is another fucking awful game. That's both on the Sega Genesis and on the Super Nintendo. So, I mean, that's a loaded statement. I plan on doing more video game related stuff, so stay tuned. Alright, next question. Have you ever seen the movie Sallow or the 120 Days of Sodom? And if so, what are your thoughts on it? Unfortunately, I have not seen that movie. I know about it. I know it's really fucked up. I do plan on watching it, but thank you for the question, Austin. Okay. Do you like Blade Runner, and which version do you prefer? This is another question that's going to be tough for me to answer because A, I have not seen all of the versions of it yet, and B, it's one of those movies that I need to honestly watch more. I've only seen it, I believe, like twice. The first time I watched it, I was not in the right state of mind. I was kind of distracted, had a lot on my mind. Second time I went into the film, like, really paying attention. So, it's definitely a film that is interesting, and I find it very intriguing. But it's not necessarily a film I go out of my way to watch. If you could go back in time, what movie franchise would you prevent from getting ruined by the studio? This is another question that is really tough for me to answer. So many franchises have been ruined already that at this point, I think the better question would be, what franchise is left that you don't want to see ruined? And that question I can answer. I do not want there to be another Back to the Future movie. I do not want there to be a Back to the Future 4. I hope that I am dead and gone before Back to the Future comes out. I do not want there to be another Back to the Future. So that is my answer. And I hope that somebody from that movie series is watching this video, which I doubt it, and they hear that. Don't do a Back to the Future 4. Just don't. Brain dead. This guy sounds like he's a complete idiot. Alright, what is my least favorite movie game? Toy line. Jesus Christ, what a fucking loaded statement. Least favorite movie would be Saturday the 14th. I know I've shown it before in one of my videos. If you're not familiar with it, go look it up. It's fucking terrible. Least favorite game. Superman 64. I gave it away. It was so bad. Least favorite toy line. I don't know if I have one. It's not my least favorite. It's just, I'm sure a lot of you will find this surprising. It's just my least disinterested. My least disinterested toy line would be The Simpsons. The new Simpsons toy line that was started a couple years ago. I don't really care for it. I don't really find it that interesting. It is what it is. So, yeah. You know, the toys that have the chips on the feet and you can put them in different sections of Springfield and make them talk and they have voices. I know a lot of you are thinking I'm nuts, but I don't really care for them. They're too gimmicky for me or something. I don't know. I just... whatever. He also asks, this is Forest / Retro or Die, Game by Night Reviews, Heavy Handed Gamer. Where is the new podcast? I believe it is Up Your Asshole.